Hello and welcome to the Admin Bar, the community that helps you streamline your processes, sharpen your skills, and demand higher paying projects. My name is Kyle Van Dusen from Ogle Web Design, just outside of Fort Worth, Texas. And today we're going to be talking to Cliff from My Web Audit. I do believe that I am looking at web audits the wrong way, and hopefully Cliff is here to set the record straight. Before we jump into that topic, first, I want to say hello to my good friend and co-host, Matt Siebert from Paria Strategic Design. How's it going today, Matt?
It's going well. And I tend to agree with you that, I do use website audits when I'm onboarding clients, but it seems that Cliff here might have way more uses for them than I've previously used. So I'm pretty excited to learn all the different things that you can do with an audit.
Tell us how wrong we are, Cliff. So good morning, Cliff. How are you doing today, sir?
I am doing great, Matt and Kyle. Pleasure to be here, man. Been listening to you guys and been part of the group for a long time. So pleasure to be here. I'm excited.
Yeah, it's awesome to have you.
We're excited to have you. So why don't you, for people who aren't familiar with you yet, why don't you give us a little backstory and how you ended up coming up with this awesome product and how you ended up here today?
So name's Cliff. I'm the founder of My Web Audit. It is a software as a service for web and digital agencies. It helps them generate leads and close more business. Ultimately, I've been running a web agency here in sunny Phoenix, Arizona for almost two decades. About 2015, we'd been using website audits in our business. At that time, that was leveraging sites like Moz, Raven Tools, SEMrush, and kind of patching them together, using them for discovery and for planning. And then part of it was for sales prep. And ultimately we realized that it was really, really time consuming and it was costly using all those different tools together just to get audit reports out. And so we spoke to a few web agency friends of ours and told them what we'd been working on or thinking of really building out as a product. They said, hey, you know, we love the idea. And that was the start of it. Ultimately, the pain points that we were dealing in our business was, you know, dealing with tire kickers who would just call us and say, hey, you know, we'd love to get a website quote. You know, people that were looking at us as commodities where, hey, you know, we want a website. And ultimately, they didn't tell us we were comparing you to offshore companies in India, Philippines, things like that. And so we would spend hours, usually an hour and a half or two, doing sales prep, getting all the things ready, only to get off the call where they say things like, oh, well, we were looking for $800 website, or, you know, we're speaking to four other companies and we'll get back to you type of thing.
I got the call the other day. They were looking for a $300 website. So it's just a little bit out of their price range.
Just a little. So yeah, I heard about you guys from a few friends, Matt Davies, Lee Jackson and a few others. And, you know, I've been part of the group for a little while now and love the content and all the work that you put in. As I mentioned to you earlier, Kyle and Matt, especially you, Kyle, love the investment you have in the community, not just delivering value, but the time you take to respond to everybody, man. It's not easy. We have a group and, you know, if I do a fraction of that, I'm overwhelmed, bro.
Yeah, it's I wouldn't recommend it for everybody. I appreciate it. Thank you very much. But yeah, it's fun. It's a good way to waste some time. So a lot of times it's just having fun and being silly, but I think that's good for all of us for our mental health sometimes, just to kind of check out for a little bit, especially when, you know, we do something technical like this. Like, I don't know about you, but like my family doesn't speak these languages. So it's nice to just be able to have conversations with people that know what the hell you do for a living. So I'm glad that we have it. It certainly helped me a ton. So let's dive into this. So, you talked about having to patch together several different kinds of tools. Me and Matt both use a similar tool to do some type of audits for clients with existing websites. I confessionally use it to audit my own website, so I make sure I don't forget things, which I actually think is pretty smart. But anyways, so let's talk a little bit about what should a website audit be and why is this an important step in especially like the discovery and strategic phase of working with clients?
Awesome. So look, most of us, if any of you are listening out there are like me, or if you guys do this right now, most oftentimes you're running a website audit on the technical aspects of things, right? So you might throw it into Screaming Frog or some sort of other tool. If you're doing SEO, then you might throw it into Moz. And then ultimately you're looking at on-page elements like meta tags, or you're looking at page speed and things like that on the technical side of things. For us, what had happened is a light switch came on in about 2013, where we said, look, instead of just using this internally for our tech team or our digital marketing side to leverage to help grow a business, what does it look like to add value upfront and educate business owners and stand out from the crowd, which literally the crowd would be something to the effect of, we can sell websites for this price and we do great, beautiful design. And right. we realized at that point, there was a lot more to do with a successful website than just beautiful design, right? So you can get themes and templates out there that can get you beautiful design, but conversion rate optimization, paid speed, user experience, those things matter. And there's a lot more focus now, 6-7 years later, than there was in 2010, 2012, 2013. So for us, like ultimately, when we talk about website audits, we're looking at it to say, you know, what information in regards to challenges or opportunities can we present a business owner that they can understand and value that helps them realize that when resolved, can grow their business. All right, so the biggest thing that had clicked a long time ago was that businesses don't hire us because we do WordPress. They might say, I want a WordPress developer because that's the technology or the tech stack, their website.
Right.
Truly, they're hiring you because they need to solve their expensive problem or desired results, which generally means I want more leads or I want to make more sales if they do e-commerce, right? So for us, website audits, whether we do them now or did them 5-6 years ago, included user experience. So UI, UX, you know, that's just simply how easy or good the site professionally the site looks and how easy it is to navigate. CRO, conversion rate optimization. How effective is the website at building trust for visitors, establishing them as the subject area expertise? That means accolades, testimonial reviews, things like that. Page performance and security. Everyone knows now page performance matters with SEO, but it makes a tremendous difference in user experience. People bounce off of slow loading pages. Security, love your care plan resource. Again, you understand the importance of offering care plans, but again, security matters. SSL, something that became a standard years ago, is still missing on sites out there, right?
Oh yeah.
And then SEO, because no matter what, you still want to make sure the site is optimized for search engine optimization, right? To get them ranked. So that's what we look for when we deliver website audits to businesses. And again, we're coming from the perspective of how do we educate them on challenges and opportunities so that we can get the sale versus, hey, you know, your website really sucks.
And I think you really keyed in on there on something that I think makes selling webs, the hardest thing to me about selling websites is that what we're selling to most of the people we're selling it to, they don't understand what they're buying at all. Mm-hmm. Like they know they need a website because they have a business and people look things up on the internet. but the ins and outs of what a website does, how it can help grow their business, and what separates a crappy website from a good website, other than those UI things that they can see and say, this is ugly or this is not ugly, even though a lot of times their opinion on what's ugly and what's not ugly is completely wrong. Yeah. But other than those like really simplistic base level things, they have no idea what we're selling to them. So I think where we get tripped up is when you feel like, okay, I'm a good developer and I'm gonna make sure all these things are done right. And you're competing with the guy down the road that doesn't give two shits and is just gonna throw together some template. Unless you can educate your customer on the difference between those things, they're just going to go on price, you know, because they don't understand that. So I think you thinking about this audit as a sales tool and as an educational piece is really important.
Yeah. And I mean, to kind of go back to what Cliff was saying about, you know, 10 years ago, sites were visual. Like that's what it was. You throw in a couple of, and it may be a little bit longer than 10 years ago, but throw in a couple of keywords, make it look pretty enough, you know, maybe a couple of, you know, dancing baby gifts or whatever, you know, those sites had. But that's what every one of my clients for the most part like understands about the web, because that's what they see and that's what they've seen for so long. And you know, the more technology is out there, the faster it grows. And so, you know, in the last 5 years, everything's just grown exponentially, and we keep up with those things, but our clients, there's absolutely no reason for them to. So most of the like the discovery meetings, and you know, people just don't know what a site can do, you know. So if they're just focusing on the style and maybe the copy, they could go with a or they in their heads, they would want to go with just a skeleton theme and it's all done. But you know, it's education really that that makes that sale.
It is. And I'll, you know, both of you guys use an audit tool. There's a lot of people out there, if they don't use our tool, they use something at some capacity. There's three things that we identified early on, and I'm going to challenge you guys, right? If you are looking to use these audits to actually close more revenue, right? The first one is, are you actually, when you run these audits, are you measuring what matters to the client, right? So if someone comes up to you and says, I'm in a small town. So for example, Kyle, you talked about living in a small community and how that works. SEO may matter if they're looking for national presence, but if not, SEO may not be that important. But conversion rate optimization for the people who actually do visit do matter. So really, are your audits measuring what matters to that client or business to move the needle, right? To actually get them results. The second one is when you do audits, and most of these audits will spit out like a 60-page report or a 30-page report, whatever it is, like how do you prioritize what actually will make an impact on that business at that point because of their needs, right? You get a holistic idea, but then you give them this list and they're confused, or you can't really spend, 2 hours going through, 500 points of different areas. And then the last point, and this is the biggest one, is how do you present all that information so that they can actually value it and understand it without their eyes glazing over?
Right.
Mm-hmm. So here's what we did with our system is, we've invested about 10,000 hours. We've got a copywriter that takes everything and ensures that it's succinct and that it means something to the business owner versus, hey, like when we talk about on-page SEO, it's not like meta tags are important because of this. It talks about the importance of how it looks on a search engine. And then it gives you an example or a picture so you can kind of get an understanding of what that looks like, right? When you talk about page speed, it isn't like, slow page, your site has a slow page speed. It actually says, 4 out of 7 people bounce if the page takes more than 4 seconds to load. So it gives them context to what you're sharing, right? So when you talk about personalizing your services, like what our audit system does is instead of just telling them I do SEO on page, website care plans, for example, you're actually able to show them a report and then tell them like these, instead of just telling you about our services, we can show you specifically on your website the areas that are lacking, and we can show you, how you can solve them. The cool part about the way we've set it up as well is that you are now able to identify challenges and opportunities they may not have thought of, or you may not have thought of, because for example, when we look at Conversion Excel, a huge authority in the conversion space. We do studies all the time on what matters for conversion. So when you go through our system and say, hey, I'm building a new site, or I'm talking to a new company, and you see that the phone number isn't in the top right, or they have no trust factors above the fold, or they aren't using live chat, for example, these are quick things you can identify in minutes to be able to present it to them. And they're like, most times they're going to say things like, wow, well, I never even thought of that. Or, Right. Wow, I didn't know that could help grow our business. And then that establishes your expertise. It helps build trust, and you're delivering value authentically versus, hey, check out our reviews, look at our portfolio, and at some level we can give you an affordable or competitive price. Right. When we do this right, you're able to charge on value.
And so I think what you said there really struck a chord with me, because what I do use to do audits, it does, the things audit softwares do, it goes through and checks for the technical factors that, do you have a page title in and a meta description and alt tags, and are there broken links, and all of those things are important. But what you're describing your software doing is much more of a communication tool with clients than these audits are, because when I run one of these audits, like these things make sense to me and I can come to those conclusions that you're talking about on some of these things, but it does me no good in communicating that to the client whatsoever, and especially in any kind of way that adds value or increases their thoughts of my ability to fix their problem.
Yeah, I was just going to say pretty much the same thing, in that a lot of the audit tools, I mean, the one that I use, it spits out a great report, but it's all tech, and it's stuff that would just confuse a client. And one of the first things that I noticed when I hopped on yours is that what it gives, I mean, those slides are beautifully put together. It's not an explosion of information. It's just what they need to understand why it's important, why it's critical, and how you can fix it. And that's something that most reports don't do, is communicate directly to the client rather than the developer. And that's something that I really appreciate with yours.
Thanks, Matt. Other things that, if you go in from the granular level, like things that we've analyzed, we use this for sales, right? So this is a platform, it's not just a reporting app. So things that we've done, different presentation views, for example, like Matt said, if you're going in and you're speaking to somebody, you can run through the HTML, like PowerPoint slide type setup. If you're going into a business, you can download a PowerPoint on the agency level. If you want a deliverable, we have the in-depth PDF report. If you're looking to export this out and change things out, we have a Google Doc report. If you work with GoWP or some other tool, a company that does services, you can export an Excel list and prioritize them and send them out in minutes. And the cool part is this: what happens when you work with a lawyer or a law firm and a remodel contractor? The verbiage cannot be the same because people think differently and use different terms, right? You may use client versus customer. And so whatever that may be, like we've built out templates so that you can hide services you don't, or audit points that aren't relevant to you. You can personalize the language, you can add testimonials, you can add call to actions, cool things like adding pixels. So let's say you do this for cold outreach, or you're dropping some sort of nurturing sequence. You can actually pixel the people that view the reports and then continue that conversation on LinkedIn or Facebook or Google or wherever that is, right? So there's a whole different layer on top of this and an approach versus just a technical website audit from an automated app. And the big thing here is also it's manual as well as automated, not just automated.
Yeah, but I can put a logo on my current reports.
Right, exactly. And you can give them a detailed report or a small report. Yeah. And there really isn't that much choice. But again, like you said, this is a sales tool. Like, installing the pixels, like using those things. And one of the first things that I noticed, aside from just visually that it's well put together, or the reports that it generates are well put together, is that you actually have each time you audit a site, you on the back end you can say, okay, I sent it, they haven't responded yet, and you've got that project management system in the background too, which is awesome for being able to keep track of everything really easily all in one spot.
Yep. So we've tried to build in not a CRM, but to give you a status. So if you're using it for lead gen,
right,
you can easily control that element. We also have the big thing here also, since it's a platform and a system, we're building resources. So we'll bring in different people. Matt Davies, for example, will be speaking with us in 2 weeks about leverage. I know he's a big fan of you guys and the group. He's like, he's a hero there. And ultimately, like getting his funnel packs and they all complement so well with our system, right? So we have an on-page report. He has an SEO funnel pack. We have a website audit. He has a website funnel pack. And so just bridging that all in, getting training to help people understand there's different ways to do this. And we have a tool called Better Leads. We could go in and find a city in Texas and ultimately just type in dentist in Austin, for example, and it'll go through on Google and find 100 different companies and tell you which ones are lacking page speed, which ones are lacking SEO, which ones are lacking schema tags. And then you can outreach, not just to say, hey, we do website SEO, like we all get, agencies right now get that type of garbage, right? And you can now specifically add value to them by giving them a website teardown, running a website audit that takes 60 seconds to do. And now you can outreach intentionally with value and personalize it to get a better response versus sending 100 spam emails out with, hey, we do web design.
Yeah, that's a big waste of time.
Yeah, that's all the messages in my LinkedIn.
Yes. So when we kind of talked pre-show, getting ready for this episode, you mentioned the leaky bucket theory and kind of how that applies to websites. So why don't you tell us a little bit about that?
Yep. So for us in our business, the biggest thing that we hear when a company reaches out to us, if it's not like we have a crappy website, it's, hey, we want to work with you so that you can figure out how to get us more leads. So then we have to then drill down and ask questions like, well, how many visitors do you have right now? How many leads are you generating? What type of website do you have? And most oftentimes they are looking to say, hey, we want SEO or we want PPC or some sort of paid ad service to generate more traffic. And so the leaky bucket theory pretty much says your website is the bucket. The holes are all the areas of opportunity. water is in essence more traffic. So if you continue to pour water into a bucket full of holes, it's not going to retain it, right? So sending traffic to a poorly optimized website is not going to help you convert more leads. And so that's the approach we take with them when we get onto a strategy call. We say, hey, look, you need a website redesign, or you're looking for digital marketing. Here's what we need to plug first. Let's look at the user experience and how easy it is. Let's look at how professional your site looks. Let's look at how well it builds trust and establishes you as an expert. Let's see how fast it loads and ensure you have an SSL and that you have no security vulnerabilities so you don't get hacked. Then we talk about other things like copy, et cetera. But the whole point is to say, if you want to get a better return on investment, whether that is going to be specifically search engine optimization, a new website redesign, or paid traffic over, let's start with ensuring we're starting with a solid foundation. And that raises light bulbs a lot of the time, because often they just think more traffic is the solution. In our agency space, you wouldn't believe how many people come to me and say, hey, look, Cliff, we just need to get more traffic to our sites. And when I ask them questions, and then they ultimately realize, like, yeah, they need to understand conversion matters. You don't just get more people to your site with a poorly optimized site, right?
Yeah. And, you know, for a lot of businesses, and you think about even like our business as web designers, we don't really, especially as somebody solo like me, I don't need a ton of traffic on my website for my website to be useful. I need the right traffic on my website. Yep. And then I need to be able to convert that traffic into an email or a phone call or, you know, scheduling some kind of consultation. But just pouring more water in the bucket doesn't do me any good. I can only take on so many projects at once anyway. So being able to use that metaphor for clients, especially the ones, because they're looking just kind of like they're looking at their website from this UI only perspective, because that's the only thing they understand. They know traffic's important. So just how much traffic can I get? In fact, I got an email yesterday. One of my clients, I've built websites for him in the past. He started a new company, and we launched a website. It's probably been 3 or 4 months ago.
Okay.
And he said, do you have any of the analytics data? And so I said, yeah, you know, I put stuff, put some reports together for him, just real simple stuff, and sent it over to him and said, you know, here's kind of what's going on. He's like, okay, well, we're getting more traffic than I thought we were. How can we get more traffic? Cause I'm not selling enough tickets. I'm like, well, we're getting way more traffic than I thought you were, like incredibly more than I thought you would be. I don't think we need more traffic. We need to figure out why people aren't buying tickets. Yeah. You know, so that's certainly a conversation we need to be having with clients more often.
And I think I always say this, if you can successfully deliver value and educate and build a successful solution, in this case, a website for your business, for the business owner, you will be successful. They will be happy. They'll get better results. You'll get reviews. And I think at some level, agencies that don't speak about anything other than UI UX when building a website, they're doing a disservice, and they're not educating people because it matters, right? Like you talked about analytics. When someone says something to the effect of, I'm redesigning a site and they have 50 pages. For example, with My Web Audit, you can connect to the analytics and within 30 seconds, it gives you 10 reports on, you know, what pages are visited, engagement, you know, least engagement pages, you know, a whole bunch of insights. And the concept here that I'm talking about is, you know, get the information so you can make the right decisions. So when you talk about redesigning a 20-page site, most people will focus highly on like the homepage. Let's say you're speaking, the agency space would be the services, and then you wouldn't touch most of the other pages because of the time and resources involved or what you're charging for. But what if some of the lower, the lower pages, the lower ranked pages are higher intent based and have higher conversion traffic? You have to be able to analyze some of that information. That's taking it to a different level. But by uncovering those type of data insights, My Web Audit does that. But whether or not you use My Web Audit, web agency owners, by uncovering those type of things, you're going to stand out from the next person who says, like, hey, look, we build beautiful websites in WordPress and we can do it for this price. And that's a huge selling point that we see people coming into our group using, and then we say, oh no, you got to change this around. I see that in your group, telling them charge on value. You know, here's how you bring value to your customers and how you add value to your business. And that again is the core foundation of what we built in.
Yeah. And when you can kind of come into any kind of sales conversation with this ammunition on your side, obviously you're going to look more prepared than most people they're going to meet with. And what looks pretty handy about My Web Audit is that you can also get all this information in a matter of minutes. Which is pretty amazing. So let's talk a little bit more about the product itself. So why don't you kind of walk us through a little bit how My Web Audit works? I do believe you offer a free trial. So I imagine people on here who are listening to this and kind of getting excited like I am about, okay, I figured out why I'm screwing some things up in sales meetings. Tell them what they're in for, what they can come to expect, and how they can get the most out of it.
Awesome. So look, there's several different ways that you can use My Web Audit. I'll theoretically just talk about some use cases. You know, you can go in and take a look at our templates. Just go to mywebaudit.com/templates. You'll see our paid speed, SEO, website, e-commerce, a whole bunch of different templates. And we have great onboarding videos. We have a community, facebook.com/mywebaudit. You can hop in on there and you'll see a lot of familiar faces there as well. But specifically, I want to speak to you about how I think, and we created this because we believe it can change businesses. It's changed hundreds of businesses, and we want that to be thousands. And we want some of you, if you feel that that's the right fit, to be in there to do it. So when you're dealing with tire kickers, or you're tired of being treated as a commodity, you're wasting hours on sales prep, you hate selling like me, and you don't have high closing rates, I highly recommend our application for your business. And here's why. So in our application, you're able to build out reports that can be used for sales prep in 5 to 10 minutes that will blow your prospects and your customers away. Okay. So that means you do sales prep for 5 or 10 minutes, and then you take this into a sales meeting or a sales call. And we have a 30-minute training video from our sales coach specifically on how to do that and how we do that. If you're doing discovery, which may be free or paid, where in essence someone pays you or says, hey, I want to work with you, and you kind of do more in-depth planning, use this, like use the analytics connection to get these insights and reports versus struggling with their Google Analytics data. You know, do a full 360 audit. If you're doing e-commerce, man, we have a 70-page report where we've taken conversion rates, and this is not standard, but we've taken them from 3.5% to 9%, right? And those, when you're doing that, that's when we can charge $70,000-$80,000 for e-commerce, or we do, $30,000-$40,000 e-commerce projects, and we can charge anywhere from $2,000 to $4,000 for an in-depth audit, strategy call, and some discovery work, right? Again, we kind of go into that in more detail in our group. Setting up productized services. So Kyle, you guys talk about care plans a lot. You talk about, you know, just what does website retainers look like? And so leveraging, you know, our system, you can easily do on-page SEO, right? Because we've taken years, decades of experience and built this in to the best practice checklist. Literally, you go in, click a few buttons, and it comes out to you, comes out with actionable reports on how to do page performance, how to do SEO, you know, on-page SEO specifically, and user conversion optimization, conversion rate optimization, user experience testing, all that type of stuff we've built in. And now you have a checklist, whether you're launching a new site, whether you're talking to someone about rebuilding a new one, whether you're building processes or selling, in essence, a productized service where you tell them, hey, for $199 or $399, we'll do an audit, we'll give you a consultation. And just understand, when someone invests some money with you, chances are they will do business with you again. And that's just psychology, and common sales will prove that, right? But the biggest thing I want to do for your group, Kyle, is I want to give them just three actionable ways that they can sign up for a trial. And honestly, I believe in 7 days, like we talked a little bit about this, like why not make it 30 days, give people a long, you know, opportunity to generate more revenue or more leads, or you know, why not?
And Cliff just said no, because I'm greedy and I won't do it.
Right. Right. And we've actually seen that in the agency space, ultimately, people are subject to shiny object syndrome. Every time there's an AppSumer deal or some new coach coming out with some new product that's going to solve all their problems. And so they jump in. And when we had a 14-day trial, what would happen is they'd be engaged for the first 3 or 4 days, and they'd drop off till they got an offer at the end, right? And we wanted them to leverage it in their business so they could see results, because that's what they get when they use it. And so we made it, we changed it to 7 days. And what's really crazy, over the last 30 days, we've had more sales conversions because people know now they have a limited time versus, hey, I'll check this out next week, right? So now let's talk specifically about, you know, how and how you can generate revenue. So this is what I want you to do. For those of you all listening, sign up for My Web Audit, you know, go through some of the basic onboarding, which is going to take you about 20, 30 minutes max, to understand how to leverage the system. Connect with your existing customers, right? Start with those that you maybe built a site a year and a half ago, 2 years ago, and then talk to them about areas of opportunity. The biggest pushback we get here is this mindset of, man, I charged them this much for a website and I didn't do half the things that are on this report, or I don't want them to think that their website sucks and that I haven't been doing my job. Listen, you'd rather talk to them and tell them that, you know, you're proactive, industry standards have changed, and you want to make sure that they have the best results, versus someone like me or one of our users reaching out to them and saying something like, hey, I don't know what your website designer has been up to, but here are some areas of opportunity that you could be leveraging today, right?
Amen to that.
So reach out to your customers. There should be no reason, and it might sound crazy, whether you charge, you know, $1,500 for a website or $3,000 for a website or $10,000, you should be able to easily make up in the 7 days, I believe, if you actively spend. Just, I challenge anyone, reach back out to me. If you spend more than 3 or 4 hours in a whole week and you can't close any deals, I'll personally try to get onto a group call and see what's going on, right? Because I believe it's that easy. Dude, I got on a call last week and these people had some SEO issues. I said, hey, here's a one-page report of your homepage and some basic information. They were like, hey, how can we do this for our top 10 pages? I said, hey, look, it's gonna be $4.99, and literally it'll take me 5 minutes to run it in our report. I'll give them a strategy call. And then it's $2.50 a page to optimize just for on-page items like schema and meta tags and stuff like that. And they have to have a minimum of 4 pages. So I could literally say I could generate $1,000 with that service and optimization in 2 or 3 hours of work, right? And sometimes it may be 7 or 8 hours depending on the processes you have in your agency, but what would that specifically look like for you? Second, you might have a few clients that had left you for whatever reason, right? Kyle, you just kind of mentioned someone where you give a bid and they reached out to you a few months later. Like, what does it look like to reach out to a few of them and say, hey, look, I know you left 6 months or a year ago. I just wanted to add something of value. We have a template, by the way, that's already built into our app. So when you go through the trial, you can just leverage that template and send that out to a couple of champion clients. Reach out if you're in groups. For example, we work with home remodel companies. If you're in groups in LinkedIn or Facebook, you know, drop a couple of, if you've already been engaged there. We all hate people who kind of come in and spam people, right? And so again, it's something like, hey, you know, I've been in this group. I'm not pitching anything. If y'all are interested, you know, drop me an email or your website below and I'll do a quick website teardown and give you 5 actionable strategies you can build into place over the next 24 hours or this week to get better results from your website. And you're just adding value versus, hey, I'm gonna sell. If there's a good fit there, it worked with you. If not, you know, you've added value to the group, especially by speaking about common things that they can, you know, leverage. And then the biggest one I would say is, if you're tired of competing with the competition and tire kickers, go ahead and leverage this on your next sales call. Again, we have, I'll link some free resources in the group whenever you post this up, guys. And I'll show you how to, you know, in essence, leverage these audits in a sales presentation to close, you know, tremendously more deals than you probably do right now, just by positioning authority, establishing your expertise and building that trust in a short period of time. Because they're coming to you, they're coming to this meeting thinking, hey, you know, this guy's going to sell me on why I should work with him. Instead, you come to them and present them with something that they think you've spent probably 3 or 4 hours on. And now you've shown them versus telling them. And then you've lit a light bulb in their head like, oh, wait, my website's more than design. And then that changes, you know, what you bring to the table and what they expect as well from everyone else.
Yeah, it changes the complete conversation. And I'll correct you on one thing. The reports don't look like you spent 3 or 4 hours on them. They look like you spent 3 or 4 days on them. All I did was go through and just run all the automated stuff and then press view report just so I could like see all this quickly. And I mean, even just the cover image of the first thing shows the customer's website on like a desktop and tablet. And I mean, everything just looks beautifully done. Like you did spend days on it. So what I think is really interesting about this, and especially looking at this, you know, through my own lens of how I run my business, is one of the drawbacks to hiring me, and I've probably said this to customers before too, is yes, I am a solopreneur by myself. I have people I can reach out to. I got a couple thousand of them here on the admin bar if I need help on something, but really they're hiring me. And what this sounds like, and kind of how I'm envisioning this working, is it's almost like you have a whole team of people behind you being able to analyze all these things. So I imagine if I was in a big agency and I said, hey, we got a real new or a real important new prospect coming in, and we want to go over their entire website top to bottom and give them some action items on everything. And you'd go to your UI person and have them do that. And you'd go to your SEO person and have them do that. And you'd go all around this agency and have people do all of these things where they're specialized in. And in the end, you'd have this report. But for somebody like me, who, you know, I'm not that deep of an expert on all of these things, because when you're kind of solo and do everything, you can't be. And two, I would never have the time to be able to put that into the types of clients I work for. It's pretty amazing that I can almost build a team of people by using this software.
Exactly. It's for those of you that are already kind of doing this, it's, you know, it saves you hours of work, right? So time is, for me, I build this out primarily because I have two girls, married, we do stuff with our church, and I just want to have a life. I used to work 70 hours a week for the first 14 years of my agency. Now I can get away with, 25, 30 hour a week in the agency and the rest of it in my web audit because of the time saved and the processes built out. And I think one of the big differences here, Kyle, that you just outlined is just, it's easy. You don't need to know about conversion rate optimization. You just go and you check a few boxes or SEO. I think 99% of all the checks we do are all automated. But then for conversion optimization, you just check a box. You can say pass, fail, and if you feel like it's irrelevant, meaning it doesn't apply to that business, you leave it alone. It automatically hides it from the report. And you know, I'll challenge myself, Kyle. Like you said, hey, look, you know, you sounds like you guys have a great product, Matt. And then y'all had mentioned, you know, one of the things we see here is price, right? Like, how do you justify that type of price for people that are just starting? And so, as a business owner, I wanted to make this as accessible as possible. The difference is, you know, do we build something where we can, you know, continue to invest? For example, we invest about 700 hours a month, sometimes more, sometimes less, but between 600 to 800 hours a month on continuing to develop this in multiple areas. So we need some sort of funding. We're still not really cash flow positive in this, 12,000 hours in. But the bigger thing for business owners that I'll be speaking to here, one is that, you know, what's your time worth? You know, what does it look like to close just one deal a month? Like I usually tell people, what does two or three or four deals look like? But just one deal a month, or to bring in one reoccurring service, right? Whether that's on-page SEO for ongoing services, a website care plan, or two, adding retainer services, you know, closing one website deal a month, or let's just say five a year, you're looking at exponentially, you know, 10, 15, 20, 30x. We tell people one good deal can pay for an annual plan. But the bigger difference here is that we've realized that if you had something for $9.99, Kyle, not only will it be abused, and I hate to say this because when we give our trials, we give access to everything, right? So we've had people come in and try to run 200 audits and then cancel before the trial and then use another email. And it's sad to say, but these are things that we deal with in our community. So we've had to spend dozens of hours building processes in place to deal with abuse, but then also say, you know, let's say in your town, do you want 15 other people using the system, or do you want to be one of the few people that are? So we're not looking to make this honestly a company where we have tens of thousands of users across the world. For me, success would look like a couple of thousand users as we grow. And the big thing is quality. Like we run our agencies, so we're not putting in place tools and strategies that don't work. Anything that does work on the lead gen side or the sales side in our agency as well as with our peers, we take that and put that in. And I feel like that area has been sorely left out in the agency space, right? There's a lot of stuff talking to you about, you know, how do you do XYZ, position your business or niche down, but the sales and lead gen space has been something I feel that has a lot of opportunity, and that's what we're trying to tackle here.
Yeah, and you know what? I think here was my honest disconnect here, right? So you went back and looked at when I had signed up for a trial initially, and it's been a long time ago. I don't remember where I first heard of My Web Audit, but obviously I heard of it somewhere, went and signed up for a trial. And my hesitancy with it was solely based on the pricing, okay? Because I know, and in talking to Matt, we are so spoiled in this industry of the price of doing business. I came from an industry that wasn't very expensive to do business in the print industry, but if we needed a new piece of equipment, you had to get a loan for it. It was going to be tens and, you know, hundreds of thousands of dollars for a printer, right? Yep. To make our business operate. And in the WordPress space, we're able to literally open a business with a computer and a free piece of open source software. So we're used to buying pieces of software like Elementor or Themes that are $50 a year, $100 a year, $200 a year. And when we get to a piece of software that's $200 a year, we're going, man, is there like a Black Friday discount? Can we get a lifetime deal on this? The truth is, operating this business is very, very cost efficient. So my hang up, because I'm in this like WordPress mindset now of how our ecosystem works, is that your product is expensive for our space.
Yep.
However, I had people like Lee Jackson and Matt Davies, who are people that I look up to and will trust. If they tell me that something's good, I'm going to believe them 100%. And I had people like them that are very enthusiastic about your product and telling me how great it was. So there's a disconnect there. And I think I've helped connect these things by, this isn't a piece of software that helps me analyze a website so I can figure out what to do. This is a sales and communication tool to close more deals. That's so right. When you look at a price like your most expensive or inexpensive plan on here, $33.33 a month, if I close one deal every 3 months, that's more than paid for itself. I think about people I offer commission to if they help me get a sale, and it's way more than $33. So when you look at it as a sales tool, the price, your perception of those prices change quite a bit, I think. And maybe it's just my hang up, but
right, because,
that's
I mean,
kind of the revelation I'm having.
Even one of those like, you know, those sales that close, if one of them or two of them, or I mean, yeah, if one of them has like a tail, like a care plan or something, and a base care plan is $75 a month, you're still coming in over that. So,
right,
you know, it's going to land you a project. It's going to potentially land you a care plan, you know, after that, depending on your processes, and you're still in the black. So, makes sense.
And so adding on to that, and again, we're running out of time, so I'll maybe end with this point is, you know, what's your time worth, right? Like the biggest thing, so let's rewind maybe 7-8 years in the business with me, right? I would just do a whole bunch of stuff. So you're stuck working in the business versus on the business. So if you're spending time like me cobbling up reports, or you're trying to reword a report from another app and you're trying to figure out how to present it, there is an opportunity lost there that you could be investing on your business. Matt, when you talk about the care plan, right? What does it look like to, like, and this is another space that people really don't speak much on, which is cross-selling or upselling existing customers. Like, we don't bring in dozens of customers a year, and our care plans right now generate over six figures, right? And that comes in from continuing to follow up with them. So when we can run a technical audit assessment, which would take any WordPress expert at least 35 to 40 minutes. And we can run that in literally 3 to 4 minutes, give you all the plugins, tell you which ones are premium, which are not, vulnerabilities, all of that type of stuff, and give that to you in minutes. And you as a business owner understand how to then present that as an area of value and then charge for that. That's priceless in many ways. And so I would extend this challenge out to anyone that's listening, you know, check it out. Don't just check it out to try it out and maybe download a template that you can reuse in your business. And if you want to do that, great. But chances are you won't be saving time and it won't help you. But do it, leverage it in your business. And if you're not able to close, like if you have some sort of a healthy business and you're not able to close that business in 7 days, you need 14 days, or you want, I have an Ask Me Anything Wednesday, right? You want strategies, you have need help. My job is to ensure that you're successful. I'm happy to do that, to ensure that anyone who's willing to invest in us, I'm willing to invest back. And if it's not a fit, it's not a fit, but give it a shot. And I think it can transform your business as you go into 2020.
Yeah, I'm super, super thankful we've had this conversation, because I think I was looking at this kind of from just the wrong perspective. Yeah. And I was looking at it as a hammer, and it's actually a screwdriver. You know what I'm saying? Yep. So I think that's been pretty eye-opening, and I look forward to hearing people's comments and stuff on this. There's links in the show notes to all this where you can get to all the information we kind of covered today. Matt, have I left anything out that you wanted to make sure we got to?
No, I think we covered it pretty well today.
Awesome. Well, Cliff, is there any parting words, or how would you like people to get a hold of you if they have questions? What's the best way for them to get in contact with you?
Awesome. Well, I'm in the group, so feel free to tag me on any questions. If you don't want to add noise there, just feel free to email me, cliff@mywebaudit.com. We have a Facebook group. Just look for My Web Audit. You'll find it. And it's for web agencies dealing with sales and lead gen. And you talked about Black Friday. Everyone's looking for something. I'll be sharing a link with you, Kyle, that you can send to the group. I highly recommend they do the trial. And if there's a fit, and use your link. We have a great deal on annual plans. If they see there's a fit there on the monthly plans, they can get an add-on for free just because they're part of your community using your link. And then I'm here to help, guys. I'm in the group, whether it's My Web Audit or not. Happy to answer any questions. I really appreciate the both of you bringing me on. And if there's anything else I can do to help you guys, reach out anytime.
Awesome. No doubt. Well, we certainly appreciate it. And I appreciate you extending that offer to our audience. That's much appreciated. All right, guys. Well, as a reminder, if this group helps you in any way, the easiest way to help us is to share the content, subscribe to our channel, and use our affiliate links. It's all free. It takes little time, and it greatly helps support the show. That is all for now. We will catch you all inside the group. Bye-bye.
See ya.